Holy Loki. This could become a new name for internet memes and for stonks. Well, actually, the real name is Holyhan Loki, and it's an investor and advisory firm, and they have got two things in common. One is Luckin Coffee, the Chinese stock that is getting in trouble recently, and Wirecard, the German startup who is DAX listed and today declared insolvency. So today in this video, I will be talking about what are the similarities and the differences between Luckin Coffee and Wirecard, and also what we can learn from it. And then I will be concluding on whether those two stocks are good for a gamble as a turnaround and betting on a recovery of these stocks. And watch it till the very end if you want to see what you can do about such cases as an investor. And as always, this is not investment advice. I cannot tell you whether you should buy, hold, or sell any stock. I'm just telling you my personal opinion, so be careful trading out there. Also, please give this video a like and also subscribe if you're new to the channel, and please also share it with your friends on social media. So first of all, for those of you who don't know Luckin Coffee, they're a Chinese startup and they have pioneered a technology-driven retail network to provide coffee and other products of high quality, high affordability, and high convenience to customers. They're empowered by big data analytics, AI, and proprietary technologies. The company pursues its mission to be part of everybody's daily life, starting with a coffee. And they were founded in 2017 and are based in China. Their goal is to quickly penetrate the Chinese market for coffee drinkers, which is actually quite big and growing and currently obviously occupied by the big players like Starbucks. They want to make it more affordable using AI and technologies in order to bring down cost and offering their coffee at a cheaper level. Then we got Wirecard, which is one of the biggest and fastest growing digital platforms for financial commerce. They provide both businesses and consumers with a constantly expanded ecosystem of real-time value-added services built around innovative digital payments by using an integrated B2B2C approach. This ecosystem concentrates on the area of payment and risk and retail and transaction and banking, loyalty and couponing, data analytics on conversion rate enhancement. So the first big similarity between Wirecard and Luckin Coffee is that they have been both involved in a massive scam and fraud, and that both companies are fighting for their survival. Luckin Coffee recently admitted that they have finessed the books, and their scope is around $300 million in revenues and expenses that are fake. And that means that the financials of the last quarters and their accounting and books are not reliable anymore. For Wirecard, the case is that they are missing €1.9 billion. So that's 1/4 of actually their balance sheet, and nowhere to be found, and recently they just admitted that it's unlikely that it's actually going to be found anymore. So one difference between Luckin and Wirecard is actually the public opinion about it. So for once, Luckin Coffee really got smashed and was a case of international politics because, well, Donald Trump, and in the US, there's lots of rumors around delisting Chinese stocks, and the fraud in Luckin Coffee has actually brought some more arguments for actually starting to delist Chinese companies who are taking US investor monies, and by making up fraud, the money is gone, and thereby US investors get cheated upon. As our channel is mostly about Chinese stocks, we see lots of comments around people saying that, well, I'm not gonna invest in Chinese stocks because they're all fraud. This is a big stereotype. And actually with Luckin Coffee, it kind of got a proven point here. But actually with the Wirecard case, you see that this kind of fraud and misbehavior is not exclusive to China. It can even happen in an economy like Germany, where actually we say that Germans are very transparent and got very high business ethics, and still, this is a startup that made it in the highest ranks of the German exchanges. So we haven't seen a big media impact on a global space. But I do think, unfortunately, in Germany, which is already quite conservative, this will have a very negative impact on the public reputation of startups in general, on new players in the financial scene and so on. And so a fraud and scandal like this will just keep on shaping this kind of bad reputation of investing in stocks in Germany, which is quite unfortunate. So one more similarity is that in both cases the fish stinks from the head, meaning that in both cases the management, the guys at the top, have been responsible for the fraud. In Luckin case it was Lu Zhengyao, and in case of Wirecard is Mr. Brown. But the consequences on both sides are quite different. Lu Zhengyao, he is still fighting for his company. Watch my latest video on Luckin Coffee, and he is still running the company basically as a chairman. On the other hand, on Wirecard, Mr. Brown, he already resigned and he actually got already jailed. even though he's out on bail right now. So the German law has been executed very strongly here by the police already. Two more similarities are that in both cases, actually, retail investors like maybe you and I, we have been quite active in those kind of stocks because they have been actually rallying, so they've been very popular, have been increasing in value very quickly. At the same time, they have been target of so-called short sellers, so people who are betting against the stock, who are betting that the stock price will be falling. And even though those short seller allegations have been publicly known and actually were quite widespread, still, lots of famous investors have actually jumped into those stocks. And actually, I also made a video about how short selling is unfolding actually in regards to Tesla and my personal experience with that. So go and watch this. And in case of Wirecard, we actually had famous investors such as ARK Invest, which I really like. At the same time, a famous German investor, Frank Thelen, who has just announced 2 days before to the scandal broke that he's been massively investing in Wirecard, which shows you that, well, he is an investment professional as well. And even he knew about the short seller reports as well. And he even got wrong and caught on the wrong foot here and now losing money. With those similarities and differences, what are the possibilities of Luckin Coffee or Wirecard to actually rebound and regain their old value? Is it possible at all? Because those companies have been quite quickly growing, but now, as Warren Buffett would say, the tide went out and those people are swimming naked. Now the fraud has been uncovered. But we see, for instance, at the Luckin Coffee stock that retail investors are jumping in at cheap prices and are gambling and betting on a return of the stock. Well, in my point of view, those two stocks are quite different in terms of how to rate their chances of survival and if it's actually worth of getting into that again. If you've seen my past videos, you will see that I'm quite transparent about my Luckin Coffee stakes and that I have actually also used the low prices to average down and betting on a good outcome on the investigation part, on changes to the management and possibly the chances that Luckin Coffee can go on because they still have some cash in the company. Also see my video about the valuation and the cash calculations that I've made. So despite the fact that there has been fraud for Luckin Coffee and it's been criminal, and I do think that there need to be consequences. It's not possible that Lu Zhengyao is still chairman of this company and walking around like this. I do think Luckin Coffee may have a tiny chance of, you know, using the billion that they have got in the bank and also the existing stores, possibly in combination with a cleanup, as outlined in my previous video, to come up with a new, more sustainable business model. There is a chance, even though the chances are not so high. I've gave a couple of scenarios, watch my other videos on that. There is still a chance for that. In Wirecard's case, I think it's actually quite different. In their case, actually, the business model was much more proven. They had a successful business case and actually they were making good revenue. The company was growing a lot, of course. And at the same time, we saw that they had big contracts with lots of firms in Germany. So the B2B and also the B2C business was going quite well. However, they have now lost all of the trust with those companies and with consumers. So I think they have been heavily burned. So now their business model is not working anymore. But for Wirecard, it seems that the financials are different. Whereas Luckin Coffee, they raised money by offering equity. Here for Wirecard, it seems that they have been getting lots of money also from banks that have been lending the money, which can now, you know, want the money back from Wirecard and thereby triggering the insolvency today. So whereas Luckin Coffee still has some financial room to play in order to ramp up their reputation once again and possibly raising new money in the future if investors are getting trust again. So here it's a story about regaining investors' trust. I think for Wirecard, the problem is on the operational, on the business side, they have lost all the trust with their partners. And also in addition to that, this leaves the investors with nothing else. There is no runtime away. And now they're going into insolvency procedure, which means that possibly investors will lose out on anything that they put into the company. And actually, that's also similar to a third case like Hertz, who is also not having enough money in the banks. And now some people want to jump into that stock and bet on a recovery. I still am very skeptical about that. So what can you do as a private investor on either you already invested in a company and you're possibly having losses right now, or if you are new to it and you are thinking about making an entry right now? So for trading high risk stocks such as Luckin Coffee and Wirecard, I've got 5 general tips that you could follow. First of all, have kind of a venture capital mindset, which means that if you are making an investment in 10 different companies, expect that just one of them is going to make it and 9 others are going to fail. If you are investing in high risk stocks, you need to trade accordingly. That means don't put all of your money into one stock. Be able to mentally and also physically lose all of your money that you invest in those particular stocks. And possibly if it's going well, you will be able to make the money with just one of those stocks that is getting a 10 or 20x and bail out all of your other stocks. This is a high risk scenario, of course. And this is how the investors like Frank Tillen are actually investing in startups, but possibly also in such kind of risky stocks. The second tip is, don't go all in at the very beginning. If a stock is there that you find attractive, don't go and spend all of the money that you want to invest in that stock in with the first chunk that you're buying. Instead, go and invest in tranches and get like 3 or 5 investments in that stock so that you get a nice average with buying the ups and the lows and so on. And also leave the opportunity to later on actually average down your costs. So if the stock falls by 80%, you still possibly have the chance in this scenario to buy back more, bringing your cost down to a very low level. Actually, I've done exactly that for Luckin Coffee, and now I'm actually on a profit on Luckin Coffee because after all of the bad news was out, it actually rose again. So now it's turning to green. The third tip would be to set very tight stop losses, which means that you automatically sell your shares or parts of your shares whenever a certain amount is actually reached. So either you take some profits in this regard, or if you are afraid to lose more, you automatically sell at a barrier of, let's say, minus 10% of your investment. Also, once you're possibly up on an investment, it's always good to take some profits. So whenever I'm up on an investment, let's say 100% up on the shares, I usually take around all of my investment out because then I can only lose what I actually won on the stock. And usually when the stock is going up and up, it's very hard to take those profits because everyone is just assuming it's getting more and more and more, and you're actually getting quite greedy at this regard. Another method that I like to use but is not an option for a less experienced trader is using options or calls in general, which is actually betting on a future share price at a certain point in time. And the benefits of such trades is that I actually need to invest less capital, so I put less of my capital at stake. At the same time, I can get larger gains if the stock is actually moving towards the right direction and if my bet is successful. And last but not least tip, and maybe that's applicable to most of you, is stay away from risky stock if you cannot handle the heat, because it's really usually a very low probability. And if you don't know in what you are investing, if you haven't done your due diligence about a stock, you actually will lose money most of the time that you're investing in such kind of stocks. So even though it's now easy with apps like Trade Republic or Robinhood to invest in such kind of stocks, just don't do it as a gamble. So it really also depends on what kind of investments you like and what is your risk profile. Because personally, I like to find really high growth opportunities that can possibly make a much higher reward than just investing in lower risk and conservative investments such as ETFs and so on. At least in a young age, I think it's still possible to possibly recover from some losses. However, this may not apply to most of the investors out there, and also particularly not if you are at higher age already. And to conclude this video with some hope and positive outlook, in some cases, such kind of companies are really resilient, and even though things are looking quite bad, actually bad news is also good because the market is then finally transparent and the truth will always come out. And in some cases, those companies can actually get back on their feet and get their together and actually get a second chance to live. And if you are really down on your position and you are in the red and you cannot afford to buy more of the shares, or you don't want to buy more of the shares, that's fair enough. First of all, maybe just see it as a lesson, even though it's been an expensive lesson. And second of all, unless you have sold your stake, you have not materialized those losses. So thank you guys for watching. Please once again smash the like button. Stay tuned for more videos, in particular on Luckin Coffee and other Chinese stocks in the future. Also, once again, thanks to our patrons for supporting this channel, and As always, investing in stocks is risky. Be careful, don't bet all of your money on it. Thanks and see you soon.